Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give it to you. They've been searching for that. I got homies that can sleep with yeah. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Come pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah, drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, ducking 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
It's the NFL playoffs on EA Sports, and we are at Wintry First Energy Stadium in Cleveland. Tonight, it's the AFC's turn to take center stage as we've got a wild card matchup on tap between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Cleveland Browns.
Matt Gay set to kick off.
The battle for the Lamar Hunt Trophy begins as we're underway in this AFC wildcard game. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. First carry now for Nick Chubb, and not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Second and nine at the 26-yard line.
Now Mayfield, and finding the tight end Hooper.
Pass.
And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
And that is incomplete.
Mayfield. This is going to be the matchup to watch out on the perimeter, and it won't be the last time these two go at it. Both of them believe they are the superior. In this case, the win goes to the defense.
And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. That'll be a 47-yard punt, officially 5 on the return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. Before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Right back to him on first down. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Now a handoff looking right. He'll get about 4 here, down to the 43-yard line.
For the running back.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to take this down close to a 1st down at the Browns 38.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Could be 4-down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on 3rd. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will have a Steelers 1st down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on 3rd and inches.
1st down, Steelers.
All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. And again, this time to the tailback. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Anthony McFarland.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
following the pickup of four. Here's second and six. Now a handoff here to his running back. And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
Now that's a mound of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on third down.
And the Steeler first down.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. And a give this time to the tailback. And he's going to battle his way down right around the two-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards. And it'll be second down.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
Farley. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2 yard line. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one.
Brings up third down.
They'll run with McFarland. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Cleveland offense ready to go. And on the first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's second and a yard from the 34. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Steelers 7, Browns nothing.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. That's caught out wide by Stills. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Mayfield finding Beckham, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. A run for Nick Chubb, and he'll take this one down to the 36.
Mayfield with the
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense.
Rush coming, and he's taken down.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. Mayfield in this Browns offense, staring at a third and long now after the sack. From the gun, Mayfield. And he finds Stills, complete. And he's going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. 7 yard line. Throwing, Mayfield. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Brings up third and six.
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. This is caught, and he'll be out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That's a big gainer on that play, and from experience, I can tell you, that's where defensive backs will come into the huddle and say, guys, how about some pass rush? But you're going to say it nicely, because those big guys up front, they don't like being criticized very much. Quarterbacks in this league, you know they'll pick you apart if you give them time.
And he'll barrel his way into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Kareem Hunt taking it in. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at seven here in quarter number two.
Seven. Austin Seibert.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad.
Is that what
he would have kissed it on the ground.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards.
Big plays always wind up being a big theme as we get rolling these playoffs, and the defenses that can avoid giving them up, but they're the teams that tend to go far. You may not eliminate those big plays, but if you can limit them, then you've got a chance to get to the ultimate game.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna take this down close to a first down at the Browns 32. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
Darren Lee on the tackle. 1 yard gain brings up 2nd and 9 at the Browns 31-yard line.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Greedy Williams picks it off. There he goes, right side. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Dancing to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Looking to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. It's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now 2 picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a 2nd one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
On 1st down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
On the carry.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Mayfield firing quickly. It's complete. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
That's a gain of 8. Brings up 3rd and 2.
That's the reason we ball for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know. 55, Mike, on 55.
That's a run. They're running it.
Joker, 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 Joker. Safe, safe, safe.
Mayfield on third and two. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Well, they'll say no to a 46-yard field goal try. They're going to go for it. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Kareem Hunt, as the first half is winding down. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage.
Austin Seibert on
CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Seibert to kick off for Cleveland.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. One more time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. They'll throw now on the final play. Brown has the first down and much more. It's complete to Brown, right side. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. On first down, they'll start with McFarland. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
A gain of 15 and a Steeler first down.
They'll set up a throw. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, Make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Offensive line wasn't set. There's the flag, and 5 yards back they go.
Quarterback has to look around and make sure that his team is ready to go. Sometimes the quarterbacks go faster than is necessary.
So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. They'll run here with McFarland. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. He'll get 2 yards back, but it's going to leave him with a long third and 13.
And it's third down.
Now back to throw. Flush to his right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack.
For a rookie first rounder, he's made a huge impact on this defense, but that tells me that they had a plan for him when they drafted him. Just turn him loose, do what you do best, go get the quarterback.
We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just 2. And the Browns will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Browns' drive about to get started. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. They run. Chubb. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
Cleveland Browns.
Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. To throw, Mayfield. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33, and they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, it's a cold night, and whether you're a quarterback that wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you, and that may have been what happened there.
Now a throw out to his fullback is complete, and they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Now a throw complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Not much there, only a yard.
You don't see too many pass-catching fullbacks nowadays, partner. In fact, you don't see too many fullbacks, period.
Good news, though, he does have decent hands, and we saw it right there on display. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. Now a throw here, hauled in, and he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
A 7-yard gain on the play, and it's 3rd down.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Now they set up a screen for McFarland. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Anthony McFarland, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Steelers have now made this a 1-score game. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Browns take over 1st and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The The Cleveland offense ready to go. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
And he'll push forward for about four up to the 23.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I?
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted.
If you were
picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski, okay? Oski
different
was an interception.
For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a
two-syllable
word.
Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. The Browns drive about to get started, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A gain of 3, second down.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 38-yard line.
They'll run with Hunt on 2nd down. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
Brings up 3rd down and 7.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And it's complete. Hooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. His 2nd catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Mayfield now. Flushed out right. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
They've given up a few 1st downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
On 2nd down, Mayfield again. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
3rd and long for Mayfield. On the left side, this is Stills.
Oh, sorry about that. I had it on mute. Nothing. What's up? Just playing Madden.
One quarter remains for the right to survive round one here in the AFC.
Yeah.
This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Dude, think he gonna beat me?
Thomas Morstead now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time.
See y'all working on a bike today.
Oh, it's a wobbler here. And no return here. This one's going
to do think he'll be
12-yard line.
At their own 12-yard line.
The The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10.
It's cold, baby. It's cold. That's what you get for thinking that, homeboy.
That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
Just for like that, I'm finna punish your ass, nigga.
Here's McFarland. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there.
Yeah, nigga, I knew you was cheating.
Nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. McFarland once more. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Give him five on the carry there.
Got you, homeboy.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
The Steelers on third down. They've hit on six of their eight tries. Very good. This will be third and 5.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. That's Claypool, fool. Let's get it, nigga.
He needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. On first down, McFarland.
You gotta stay on your block, Claypool.
Back at the 41. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's gonna bring up second and 11. Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself, thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
Come on, Claypool.
Running back. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. They couldn't get anything going there out of the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
How? This nigga's playing zone and they're sticking with him. I don't understand it.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And the Browns will take over, first and 10.
They're on 24-yard line.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter.
Let's go, baby. You're not getting that, oh boy.
Right side. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4.
You know, the key, I know what you're trying to do, homeboy.
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Yeah. Let's get it, homeboy.
That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Hey, crossing routes. Let's get it.
Now a second down throw for Mayfield. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on.
You still there, Knuckles?
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
Mayfield off the play fake. Escaping the pressure right.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. Where you going, son? Where you going? Put me the ball. Now it's time for daddy to go to work.
But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move?
Let's go. Let's go. Now it's time for daddy to go to work. Now it's time for daddy to go to work. Let's put this work in. You're what? They should be right there. I didn't throw nothing away, Tracy. Well,
there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now, but they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Getting down to the good stuff, all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset, and let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line.
The Steeler ball carrier. The tackle made at the 47-yard line.
They're going to look to throw. And that's going to be caught. It's Rico Gafford. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. Ground, it's McFarland. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Brings up second and 8 at the 44-yard line.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Get this to his running back, Edmonds.
Let's go.
Right near the 35-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Pittsburgh.
No, I'm not gonna run that. I see what you're trying to do, homeboy.
McFarland. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20.
Let's get it, dog. Let's get it, homeboy.
60,000 thinking pass right there, including us in the booth.
Let's go.
That was a big call, big guts on that one. And guess what? That run, it'll pay dividends.
Let's get it, nigga. Let's get it.
From here, let's see how they play it on first and goal. Again, McFarland. And that's a touchdown.
Let's go.
They've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control.
Let's get it.
But still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Their own 21-yard line.
Ready? Mayfield to throw.
Really? You should know better than that, homeboy. You should know better than that. You should know better than that.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Rico Gafford, the intended target. And now it's second down. Denzel Ward. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to try and go deep again.
Oh, he missed it.
7 seconds remaining. Rico Gafford, the intended target. And it's third down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On third down, here's McFarland. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Oh boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. And he'll be tackled inside his own 15. The decision to bring it out cost him some yardage. They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round. Well, they just got past the wild card round.
How about that, being able to put the big check marks up in the locker room, right? Get, you know, get to the wild card game. Check. Got that done. Win a wild card game.
Hey, I'm gone, boy. If you're on.
So that'll do it for us.